Hey guys, happy new year! Welcome back to my channel. I'm Kristen with icstarsquilting.com. I share tips, tricks, and tutorials for the modern quilter. And today we're gonna talk about how to go from like beginner quilting stages to looking like an expert really, really fast. I know when you first start out quilting, there is so much to learn. There's so much that you have to keep up with, and there's so much that you have to get better at. You're just not very good at some of these things, and it comes with practice. We want to be able to create a project, get it done, be happy with it, feel good about it, feel good about gifting it to somebody else if that's the reason that you're doing these quilts, and then move on to the next one. Now, that part in between where you're getting better as you're slowly moving along and you're going project to project, I guarantee your skills will increase. But that's not the part that we like, right? We want to go from beginner to expert like that. There's a few tips that I picked up while I was learning and getting better that didn't make the road quite so bumpy, okay? So what we're gonna do is, remember, we wanna work smarter, yeah? Smarter, not harder. So I have 5 tips for you today, okay? 5 tips. And those 5 tips start with this one. Stitching in the ditch. Don't do it. Don't do it. Okay, I know that's like everybody's like beginner first quilting project. They're like, I'm just gonna stitch in the ditch. It's okay. I don't really know what I'm doing with the quilting. I don't know how to be creative with the quilting lines. I don't know how to make it fancy or do all the free motion stuff. I'm just gonna quilt right there in the ditch and nobody will ever see it. Here's why that's not the best plan. Because if you squiggle, right? You know, your quilt, it wiggles while you're quilting on it, okay? The squiggle, that's what I call it, it's a squiggle. If it squiggles, what's the first thing your eye is gonna see? It's not gonna see all the times that you laid perfectly in that ditch in between your seams, okay? Your eye is gonna go to that point where your needle went right around where it was supposed to go, right? And then you're gonna see that flaw. It's not gonna matter that you did it perfectly on all the other ones, you're gonna see that flaw. So here's my advice on that, okay? Don't stitch in the ditch unless you absolutely have to. That's all there is to it. Just don't stitch in the ditch if you're trying to look like a more professional quilter, okay? Here's what you need to do instead. Echo your seams. Okay, even if it's just straight lines on a patchwork quilt, okay, echo those seams. Like I have in this example right here, you can see where I stitched 1/4 inch on either side of my seam. I didn't stitch in the middle. So it actually ends up looking decorative. It looks a little bit fancier, but really I didn't do anything special. I just stitched next to it. Now, if while I'm stitching and I'm still learning how to, like, you know, battle with the weight of the quilt and like make sure everything goes through my machine correctly and stuff, if I get a little bit off, you're not going to be able to tell as easy. So you have all of these lines that are like parallel to your seams and they're going really easy. And now you can do this on shapes, you can do this on triangles, but I really, really like echoing those seams. Ditch, stitching in the ditch. That is my number one thing, okay? Tip number 2. If you still want to do straight lines and you kind of want to experiment or you want to go on that diagonal or something, try these, okay? Try these. This is like a chalk pencil. This is like a chalk crayon. I really, really like this one right here. So it has like these little teeth on it and it just has chalk dust powder in it, but I really like it. So when you draw on the fabric, you have this nice, crisp, clear line of chalk. And then when I'm done with it, it's usually gone, okay? Or if I mess up, you just hit it a little bit and it's gone, okay? So I really like that chalk marker. I'm gonna put a link down below to the products that I like using, just in case you wanna get the same ones. You know, it helps to have a good recommendation, right? I also like friction pens. These erase with heat. this is really good to draw your lines on your quilt so you have that plan in your head. You're not just winging it as you go, okay? Again, we're working smarter, not harder. Another thing that you can do if you're doing diagonal lines is really, really quick, get some painter's tape, okay? Painter's tape is just a really low tack. It's that blue tape that you can get from the hardware store. Or washi tape works the same. That just is, tends to be a little bit more expensive, I guess. But if you have lots of it laying around and that's what you have on hand, that's awesome. Something that's low tack that you can just kind of put from point A to point B on your quilt and then sew right next to it. That'll give you a nice straight line if you're not following your seams or if you have a big panel that you're trying to quilt. It can gum up your needle if you try and go through the tape, okay? So go next to the tape, not on top of the tape. That'll help you get nice, clean, straight lines as well. Okay. Tip number three that I have, when you want to try something new or you're like, this would look really cool on this, okay? So if you have put together and pieced this gorgeous quilt that you're proud of, right? You're proud of it. You're still kind of in that novice type beginner stage. You don't want to try something brand new, okay? Give yourself a little bit of a practice round. Just make like small quilt sandwiches, okay? That are like maybe like, 12 by 12 or 15 by 15, however big you have. If you have like an orphan block that you practiced on and it didn't make the final cut into your quilt because you decided to redo it, that is a perfect practice piece, okay? Do not practice on your big final quilt piece. Yes, you can pick out those stitches. Like if you mess up and you don't like it, you can sit there with the seam ripper and you can start over. There's nothing wrong with that. However, if you're gonna try something new, why not do it on a practice piece that isn't your final piece and doesn't really matter in the big scheme of things? Okay, number four, make sure you have the right tools on hand, okay? You don't have to be fancy. You don't have to go and buy the whole fabric store of tools and that whole aisle of notions. You don't have to have all of that. However, if you are frustrated and things aren't working right, it could be that you are setting yourself up for like a disadvantage because you don't have the tools that can really help you get to where you want to be, okay? That's just how it is. You can't make a cake if you don't have flour and you're trying to substitute all kinds of other stuff, okay? It doesn't work that way. Same in the sewing room. Some of the tools that I really recommend having is a walking foot. This is a must, okay? This is an investment. It doesn't have to be a huge investment. You can get it off of Amazon. I'll put the link down below to the ones that I recommend. But this really helps when you're quilting, okay? So when you have your machine, that walking foot has like an extra little handle thing on it, and that is going to help move your fabric through the machine. It's actually going to use like the feed dogs on the bottom and on the top, and it's going to take it and it's going to pull your fabric through like this, as opposed to just this way, because you have a much thicker area to work with, and the batting also can shift in between, and that's just like, that's something that you can't fix, okay, without a walking foot. So make sure that you have a walking foot on your domestic machine while you're quilting, okay? Another thing that is really, really helpful is quilting gloves. But this is one that I got that I had recently. Now it's kind of like rubbery on this side, and you can see it's very like, it's just stitched on there. It's got a rubber pad right here. And then the other side is just Velcro. So it goes around my hand, and I like it because I live in Texas. It gets hot. I don't want to wear gloves all the time because then my hands get kind of like hot and sweaty and gross, and I don't want to do that. So I like this. It's nice and open, and it seems to work really well. So you're not actually grabbing like with your fingers on the quilt when you're moving it through. You're pushing with the palms of your hands and moving it through. So this just kind of provides resistance. So I can help move the weight of the quilt with the needle and go with it, okay? So I can push down on the quilt and help move it through. Now the other thing that I have is these. Now I've had these for a long time and these work great. These are kind of like socks, those non-slippy socks that you put on like little kids so they don't fall down while they're wearing their socks. It's kind of like almost like a garden glove too, right? It has some resistance to it. It works the same as those other ones, except it covers all of your hands. They're just regular gloves. Nothing really special except for this right here. You can find them at the craft store. You can find them on Amazon, and I could tell you like a million other tools to have on hand, but when it comes down to it, those are the ones that are going to be most beneficial to you, especially that walking foot. Okay, and then my very last tip, and probably the most important one, is to make it look like it was on purpose, okay? If you're quilting, you're trying something new, and you get a squiggle or you decide that, man, I cannot do straight lines to save my life, okay? I don't know how to do it. I can't figure it out. That's okay. Make it look like it was on purpose, okay? Now you gotta think a little bit, okay? You gotta think a little bit. If you don't wanna go through and pick out that stitching and redo it, make it look like it was on purpose, okay? Do like a funny little design in there, or you know, do some squiggles and some wavy lines over on this side of the quilt so your eye can kind of like travel around to those spots and somebody goes, wow, that's really abstract and really, really pretty, right? She added her own flair to it. That's awesome, right? Nobody has to know it's not a flair, it's a total mess up. But the only way that they will know that is if you tell them that. Just know that it's not going to be perfect. But you can do some things. If you know that you are not good at doing straight seams, don't do straight seams, okay? Nobody has to know that but you, right? Add some waves in there. You know, do something that hides those mistakes a little bit more, okay? That's what's really going to make it look like you didn't mess up. That was on purpose. Totally not an accident, and that's what I meant to do. Do your best. Know that the more you quilt, the more you piece, the more you do this craft, the better that it's going to be in the long run, right? In between, take those 5 steps that I told you, make sure that you keep those in mind while you're learning, okay? And that is going to help your quilting get better as you're still picking up those skills, okay? Take those tips and tricks and tutorials that I give you in my videos, put them to good use. You're gonna be amazing by the end of this year. I cannot wait to see what you create. Keep in touch with me. Write down in the comments down below. Let me know what you think. I love hearing from you. It's gonna be a good year. This is gonna be a great, great year. I have lots of things to create on my end and more tutorials to come. So make sure that you are subscribed to my channel, please, okay? Hit that little red button in the corner, subscribe. That way you'll be notified when I post a new video. My name is Kristen with iceystarsquilting.com. I hope that you have a wonderful day. I'll talk to you again soon. Bye.